Right, lads, check your party.
Welcome to Malaysia as we head into the all-important qualifying session.
You should be able to talk now, Rob.
And we're just waiting for the lights to go green to signify the start of the...
Yep, I'm live.
Robbie?
I'm here.
Amazing.
All right, cool. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Sepang International Speedway. It's BK on the Xbox, Beer and Kebab, the Racing Guru. Welcome to Sunday Race Night. And we have Stig and Robbie. Good evening, chaps.
Good evening, Beer. How the devil are you? Where were you Friday night?
Well, I had a house full of people, got thoroughly drunk, and I would have been a bit of a mess. Actually, a bit of a mess.
To someone else in your house to play it.
they could probably go a lot faster than me anyway, mate. Yes, my four-year-old could do a better job than me. But yeah, should be a cracking race tonight. If last Sunday was to go by looking at the how close it was the first few laps of all the mental stuff, wow, should be great. But right, I'm going to jump on board with somebody. Got to try and remember what to do now. It's been so bloody long.
Well, Luke's out straight away. Alonso's just following him out now. Coming out of the pits.
Yeah, it's Colin Dino.
There's a few out on track.
Who's the lead car, mate? I'll jump on the lead car. We'll,
it's Luke.
Mr. Warren Luke. Let's go on, jump on Mr. Warren. There we go. Just on his outlap in the Force India. Of course, the Force India, very quick in a straight line, does not like corners. He's just mincing around at the moment, going for the two right-hand turns. Getting his tyres all warmed up on the option tyre there. Of course, for this track, the option tyre is the white wall. The red is the prime tyre. And of course, being as it's Malaysia, we're probably going to see green wall tyres and probably even blue at some stage because it's going to rain.
Yeah, they were needed on Friday night. It was rain for the last four laps, heavy rain it was.
Yeah, in fact, it's looking a bit ominous up there right now, looking at that sky, some dark clouds. As Luke makes his way.
We can't hear what the garage is telling them regarding the weather.
Well, absolutely. Anyway, Luke comes around the final corner. Just straighten that car up, hit the DRS, and he's just about to cross the line to start his first hot lap. So we'll stay on board of Luke. So he comes down the main straight, up to top gear, brake around 100 metre board. Just running that through, probably in second gear. Swinging the car left. Quickly going up for the gearbox. Fast bit of track now. Long right-hander, a little bit of straight, going up the hill to a tight right-hand corner, a 90-degree corner. Yep, nicely through there. Then we have a tricky one here, a left followed by a right, and you have to just lift off a tad to get to kiss the apex and get the right line through. Yeah, but that's nicely done. The two fast right-handers drop to fourth gear, and then power down through the corner. Ooh, cut across the grass there. I'm not sure if that was a corner cut, but definitely borrowed a bit off the grass. Coming into the tight left-hander, going up the hill. The car just seems to bog out a little bit going up the hill in second gear. Then this one's probably the hardest corner of the track, I think. Or one of the second hardest corners. It's really hard to get right, but he's done that well. A long left-hander. Sweeping right, and then into, again, another tight corner. It's a blind corner. The track sort of falls away a little bit. Reverse camber. Nicely through there. 33.5 second sector. So that's all good. Comes flying down the main, well, the back straight. Into the last corner. Third gear, opens up DRS, and he crosses the line with a 138.4. That's not a bad bank lap, is it?
No, it's steady there. It's
yep. He's got his fast lap.
138.1, George's.
Oh, George has gone a bit quicker in the second. George's in the Sauber, I think, isn't he? I think Luke's going again, though, by the looks of it. Just stay on board.
His time's not registered, I don't believe.
Ah, yeah, must have been where I mentioned that he borrowed a bit off the grass. You know, the two right-handers.
Ah, there's a 137. There's a 137.867 there from Colandino. That's quick. Instead of 137, yeah. That's a good time. Yeah.
That is a good time. This is where Luke he's borrowed a bit there, but I think he might have got away with that when it was more sort of two wheels on the curb as opposed to two wheels actually on the grass. So I think he might have got away with that one.
Well, Creations is 137.4. That's a very good time.
That's a solid time, that. Solid time.
Yeah, that could leave him on the top.
I think some of the chaps, yeah, they have hit the high 136s in practice during the week, haven't they? In qualifying times.
Yeah, it changes. I was 137.1s Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. It got to Friday, pre-race practice, and it was 138.3s. What? I was like, what?
Well, this is a good time by Luke. I think this one, he's quicker this time, definitely. Yeah, this is a good time. He's done a good lap here, as long as it's
very
clean.
Very good time. 137.2.
Yep.
What is it? What's it got? 137.2? Oh, it's not registered again.
Is that, yeah, I think he's been...
Oh, yes, it has 138.2, sorry.
138.2.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we'll jump on, we'll find somebody else. Alonso is coming into the pits. Ah, DRL Mansell, there we go. Mr. Hammer. He's on the prime tyre. Which is an interesting call. Obviously, he's looking at changing his strategy. He comes down the back straight. Hard on the brakes. Try and keep it tight as you can. Oh, no, he's actually backed out. He's in the pits. We've got Sam in it now. I'll stay with Sam. Decent first and second sector. Bored a bit off the grass there. Coming into the blind right-hander at the start of the back straight. Hits the DRS. Flaps open. As he comes down to the final corner on the brakes, try and keep it tight so he can get the power down the exit. Yeah, he's done that pretty well. This could be a good lap for
Sam. Yeah, that's a nice quick time. The 137, it's not registered.
Yeah, it's not registered. Yeah, and he's ghosted it, so he's backed out of this one.
Yeah.
Who seems to be going around in first gear, revving the hell out of that engine. Creations coming out the pits.
Oh, he's already set the fastest time as well. Does he think he can go quicker?
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm just going to drop onto the
lap times. He's coming in.
Okay. Stig, are you there? Is Stig not even there? Well, just a quick rundown of the... of the grid. As you can see there, we've got Creations with a 137.4 and provisional pole. Colandino, 137.8. Then Skinny, 138 flat. George, 138.1. One Luke, 138. Sam, also 138.2. Just literally 3/100ths of the second splitting them two. Alonso, 139.1. And Mansell on 139.2. Because I think those last two will be probably on the prime tyre. Because I know Alonso likes to start on the prime. And the actual weather forecast for qualifying is actually cloudy start with showers possible. We might yet see an interesting end to qualifying session. We'll jump back on board. Let's find somebody on a hot lap. There's Sam going again. No, he's backed out.
DRL Mansell's on a hot lap, I believe.
Yeah, he's going there, isn't he?
It's a nice track for this car. The car seems to... It seems to suit the car.
Well, of course, you won Friday night's race. Congratulations for that. And, of course, you won it in a Williams.
Yeah, I did, exactly. It's a good car. There's some speedy corners. It's not too bad through the speedy corners.
I just found during the week when I had a go at practice, I just felt the Force India, even though I managed to find a setup that gave me a stable back end, it was just struggling on qualifying pace. But during a race, it seemed to be okay, but just on the on the hot lap, didn't want to know, 138.
Yeah. But obviously now we're on realistic performance. If you get a knock in your car, it will affect the performance of your car.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's just borrowed a bit out of the corner there, Mansell.
Yeah, he wasn't a hot lap either. It wasn't.
He's just running out. Is he just getting his tyres warmed up for the big one? And he comes into the last corner. Again, he wants a nice tight entrance. Look at that. That's
a nice
good
line.
Yeah,
that's a beautiful line through there.
Get that power down early. And of course, that Williams is ever so quick in a straight line. Very fast in a straight line.
It's a good all-round car. We've not done any tight street or tight circuits yet, but I'm sure it'll be fine, I'm sure. Mm. He's looking good through.
We're looking at first sector, low 24s, aren't we, for a good split time for the first sector. Let's see what he does.
24-3, that's
quicker. Yeah, that's quicker. That's quicker. Well, I've just got a message from Stig. I'll check that. I'll just stay with this lap for the minute, then I'll check the messages there. I think he's obviously got some kind of connection issue with his Xbox tonight. And I think it's a 33 something for sector two, isn't it? I think they normally try and look about 33 something.
Kai's quickest so far. Kai's got a 124.1 in sector one. He's just coming up on sector two right now. He's looking very good. Go on to Kai. Yeah. He's looking very good.
All right. I'm just 33.4 for Wayne. I can probably jump on Kai for the final sector because I think he's that far ahead of Wayne.
Kai's quicker. He's looking very good.
What's his sector two time?
Oh, no, I think he's back to 133.6. He's backed off.
Okay. Well, Wayne's still going. He's going down the back straight now, coming to the last corner. This is the critical part. If you can get this corner right, early braking, get nice and tight, and then power out. A little bit wide there.
A bit like last time.
Yeah. I still think it's a good lap, though.
If it's a clean lap.
137.7 puts him into second place.
137.7, good time.
Yeah.
He's into the 137.
And he lost a bit. Ran just a little bit wide. Okay, who else we got currently on a fast one? Oh, Skinny's on a fast one. I'll come and jump on with Skinny. 24-1 first sector. That's very quick.
He's
lost it. He's backed off.
He's backed off.
I think that was a quick time. It was, wasn't it? Okay, let's see what we got. Jism's just meandering around. Forrester's going around in first gear in his primes.
Kai's going on another one.
Yeah, Kai's gone again.
Going on another.
24 flat, 21. Sector 1. Sorry, Robbie, I was talking over you. Do apologise, carry on.
Was that Kai?
Yeah. 24 flat, first sector. I think it's the quickest so far. Oh, very close to being the quickest.
He's got
some traffic in front. Hopefully that'll get out of the way. It does. Well done, whoever that was.
Down into second. Pulls it in.
It just bogs down a little bit, doesn't it, when you come up the hill there? Just the engine.
No, it's a good. I like that corner.
33.5. That's not bad.
Yeah, he's nailed this.
He's lost a couple of tenths though compared to Wayne's time in the second sector, but he was quicker in the first sector, so we could be close here. This is a tough corner to get right.
You see, he's got it just right. Maybe a little bit wide, but he's looking very quick, very very quick. This could be late 36.
It's a good lap. Can he nail this final corner in nice and tight? He's managed to get on the power very early. I think this is a pole lap, I think.
That is a late 36.
137.7. I think that's just a tad faster than Wayne Hammer. I just need to get to check me messages, Robbie. It's going to just pause for a second on the broadcast. Right, I think Stig's got a connection problem. Oh, a quick message there from One Shop on the feed. All the best for tonight, lads. Yeah, much appreciated, One Shop. Shame you can't race with us at the moment, but you're always a part of DRL. Right, he says he's messaged me on Facebook. Oh, here we go. Dear Beer, you suck. Interesting start. Just kidding.
Tag's looking pretty good. Maybe could put him up into fourth, maybe.
Okay, yeah, Stig's going to stay in the lobby. Oh, sorry. I'll jump on Skinny's cart. There we go, just finished it off. 137.7, good time.
Stig's just invited me.
He says he's having problems with the party and whatnot. He can't get in, so he's going to stay in lobby. He's not going to quit the lobby. In fact, we'll try and invite him back in. Can you try and invite him back in there, Robbie?
Yeah, I will know.
All right, cheers, pal. A quick look at the...
Oh,
yeah. Oh, wow. Wow, that looks close. Do you know what? We've got... six cars, yeah? And we've got 1 second covering the first nine cars. That's close. That's really close. We've got 2 minutes left in qualifying. And we've got Creations on a 137.4 in first. And Colin Dino in six on a 137.8. That's how close it is. Oh, blimey. It's going to be mental in the first lap. Right, let's see if we can find somebody on a hot one. I think one Luke's just about to start a quick one.
Hey there, Stig. Stig's just joined the party.
Yep. He's got some kind of connection issue tonight, isn't he? I don't know.
And 24.2 there from Luke. That's pretty good. And he's
It's not bad for sector one. That Force Indy should always be good in the first sector because of the speed it's got, you know, and in those two little bits of straight. This is a good
he's
lap.
He's lost a lot of time on that corner. He's lost a bit of time on that corner, though.
Oh, you mean, the little sort of left-right swing, don't you? It's hard to get right, that. Interesting to see what he's got in his, sector time, in sector two. Normally it's about sort of mid-33 second, so... he's lost a lot of time.
He's lost a lot.
Unfortunately, he's lost a lot of time.
He's got that corner nail.
So we're down to the last minute in qualifying now.
Oh, a little bit wide on there.
Yeah, just a little bit hesitant getting on the power coming out of...
He could be looking at a late 137. If he nails this last corner, he could be looking at a late 137.
So he wants to go wide, swing it in.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, that was
nice. Power down.
Get on the power, DRS open.
Yeah,
I think it's 38 this one, I reckon. Yeah, 38.6.
Yeah.
Right, let's... Venoms is on a hot lap. He's just put a 24.1 in the first sector. And the Toro Rosso, I think he's in. Nicely through there.
Beautiful.
He ran the gears beautifully through there. Just dropped down a couple of gears and then powered down again. That was good driving. Oh, nice slingshot through there.
Hello, Stig.
Yeah. I'm having too many problems. I don't know what's wrong. But it's just work away, and I'll have Twitch sorted out for next week anyway. My account is unfroze on Tuesday. So.
Okay.
I think there was a problem because there was the link between the two Twitch accounts. Obviously, because one of my accounts is feeding the gold onto my other account, it copped on and froze my account Twitch feed.
You're here now, that's what matters.
Yeah, well, it's still causing me problems with my speech and stuff, so there's no point. I'll just stream is fine, so I can keep an eye out for incidents or anything like that, or from whatever you catch.
Yeah, no problem.
And, I'll just Twitch as normal as next week. My account will be back on Tuesday, so.
Are you currently including your audio at the moment?
I think so.
Okay. Well, call it. Checker flags come down, so there'll be a couple of drivers, a couple of stragglers on hot laps, I'd imagine now. I'm stuck on the normal screen, so I can't tear the lap times. At the moment, as far as I know, DRL Creations is in pole position.
I've taken my audio off there.
I'm okay. That might be your connection then, mate, because we're okay here. It's been fine. Well, it's fine this end, yeah. Robbie, could you do me a favour? could you take me take a screenshot when we get the qualifying times up, mate, please?
Yeah.
Cheers, pal.
Definitely. I believe it's Creations, Mansell, Kai, Shag, Pure Venoms, George, Colandino, Saminit, Lon Luke, Jism, Alonso, and Forrester. I think that's the order.
I haven't really read it yet, mate. I will read it when I get a chance, buddy. Ah, right, okay.
And that's pole for Pastor Maldonado, who put together a stunning... Xbox, take a screenshot. ...off to beat in tomorrow's race if he can show the same pace as he did
today. Hmm. Okay. Hang on 2 seconds. We just got the qualifying times up. As you can see, Creations first, Mantle second, Kai Pollitt third, Skinny fourth, Venoms fifth, George sixth, Colandino seventh, Salmon eighth, One Luke nine, Jism 10, Alonso 11, and Forrester 12. Jism and Forrester on the prime tyre.
Seven as well are in the 137.
Yeah, look at Jism. Just a second down on the pole time, and he's on the prime tyre. Watch Jism in this race. He's going to have some pace there, I reckon. Just a second down and he's on the prime tyre.
He's a reliable driver as well as Jism.
He's steady.
He avoids incidents. He's steady away. Yeah, he's a good driver.
But there we go. It's a dry start, but it's looking cloudy, looking ominous there. There's some cumulonimbus there in the background.
I believe it's going to be rain about lap 22, 23, if not earlier.
Yeah.
That clouds are looking heavy.
It's looking bad, isn't it?
Yeah.
But yeah,
and
obviously
they've got the setups for dry. It's going to be
well,
good.
This is it. Performance modes in the wet. It should be very interesting. Later on, Luke will call, and then once everyone's set, the countdown will appear. When the countdown gets to zero, Robbie and I will peel off to the side of the track and retire so we can then concentrate on the lead cars. As hopefully there'll be some fantastic overtaking and battles and not too much carbon fibre spread all over the track.
And there was a little bit of an incident on Friday night in the first corner. There's a few little bumps and scrapes, but
yeah.
It was okay.
I've not really had a chance to really look at Friday night's race. I did upload it as soon as I got home from work on the Saturday, but...
Oh, there was some very good racing. Really, really good racing. Especially between me and Secchi, it was very good. But now just the anticipation waiting.
Oh, yeah. Getting the butterfly feeling in my stomach already. What's going to happen?
Yeah, but in the new game, you've got the clutch start.
Oh,
the new
man,
game looks absolutely fantastic. Have you seen the career options for the tyres and the practice for the whole full weekend and stuff like that? It's phenomenal. They've really, really gone back to the essence of the F1 game franchise they have, and it's going to work an absolute dream, I think.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it. Less than 3 weeks to go until it comes out now.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly. Oh, looks like they're off.
Yeah, the clock is ticking.
You have 21 seconds to comply.
Yeah, hopefully they've all come back from their toilet breaks. Got suitably nicotined up.
The other night, when I was racing, my first pit break, I went to the toilet, ran to the toilet, weed, got back to my seat just as my car was there. I did that twice.
I need to get a potty right next to me. Right, they're off, so we're going to just pull over, let them go on about a second at the road.
We'll do that with teabags in a bit.
And then pull over to the side.
I might go a little bit.
Off they go. Off they go, and we will just pull over, retire from session.
Doesn't seem to be any incidents.
And here we go. I'm on board
with
Alonso watching in. Oh, Venoms has gone wide. Venoms and Kai Pollitt have gone across. Oh, there's Carnage in the first corner.
Yeah, somebody spun.
Alonso's gone round as well. Oh, dear, oh, dear. You've got Jism,
Alonso,
you've got
Kai,
Forrester.
And Shag. Shag's been taken out
Kai.
As well. I'm just watching Shag. Shag's in last place. He's just gone round the corner now. Hopefully,
okay.
I don't think anybody clipped the wall.
All right, thank you for that.
Do I retire from session?
Please tell me you did. Otherwise, that's the... that would be the cause of the accident. No, I think you did, mate.
No, it wasn't it. I was miles behind, mate.
Yeah.
Do I retire from session, yeah?
You should have done, yeah.
Yeah, right, right. Cool. Right, I didn't realise that. Board. I opened that wouldn't.
Right, currently on board with Creations in first. We've got DRL Mansell in second place at the moment in the Williams. Behind him, we've got, the two Force Indias, actually. They've both got good starts there, third and fourth, which is Sam in it and DRL One Luke. Fifth place with Sauber.
Is Shag? Where's Shag? Oh, there he is. There's Shag. I want to get back on board with Shag. He was very, very unlucky there.
Yeah, we are coming into the last corner of the first lap. We've got an overtaking move there. We've got Sauber and the two Force Indias side by side. I'm going to jump on board with Force. Look at that. Look at that view there. We've got one loop. We've got George. We've got Colandinho. We've got everybody. Look at them all. The side by side going into turn one. Can he all get through safely? Sam, I think, has just held his teammate there. Luke tries to undercut him. It's not going to work. Sam takes on George. George has gone the inside of one Luke there. He's going to be alongside one Luke.
He's not. He's dropped off as George. He's yielded. He's got Colandinho tight up his
bumhole.
Well.
Yeah.
George is all over Luke's gearbox. Oh, he's George's got a little nudge from Colandinho.
Colandinho
held his ground. Luke's looking good.
Colandinho had to get out the... Sorry, mate. Colin had to get out of the way sharpish there, didn't he? Otherwise, that'd have been a rear ender. In fact,
Luke's
that's just allowed.
Pretty,
yeah, he's just tucked him behind his teammate. Yeah. Just tucked him behind his teammate.
Working as a team.
In fourth place. Of course, have you noticed there that the Creations in Mansell and the Williams, they've already opened up a bit of a gap there, a couple of seconds already on the Force Indias. And George is going to get the inside there of. And he's made the move stick. George has gone up the inside of Colandinho there. They did swap positions. He's taken his position back again. Good bit of driving there. Just on board with Sam. And Luke's sniffing all over the back of Sam there. And I think Luke might have a look here, you know. I'm just going to stay on board with this particular battle. Luke's sneaking around there, trying to put pressure on his teammate in the slipstream. Pulls out along the left-hand side. And I think he's going to... And then will he tuck back in time? Through the corner... Yep, and Juan Luke has taken third place from his teammate. A nice overtake. Both drivers gave plenty of room. Good driving. Nice to see. So Luke leads into third. We've got Sam in fourth, and George is really feisty in that. Sauber in fifth, with Colandinho in sixth, and then the Lotus of Kai Pollitt, I think, in seventh place. And we just heard from Stig there. His audio is not included, but Luke's not on his screen. He's definitely there. You've definitely got a connection problem there. Yeah, the stream's fine. It seems okay. There's no lag in the room at the moment, certainly from a streaming perspective. But the
Mansell's taking the lead at the front.
Yeah. That's sloppy commentary from me. I've missed it. Hang on, let's jump on board. And Mansell has indeed taken the lead out from the Lotus. Just looking back there for Mansell's car. We'll try and get the bird's eye broadcast view. Good defensive line there by Mansell into the tight left-hander as well. That's one thing about Wayne, he's a very good defensive driver.
Yes.
You know,
and
he makes that car
wide. He's aggressive
wide.
With it, but he's not ridiculous.
Mm. Creason's got to get the inside there. The back end just stepped out
here.
There. But
he's
I think
got
he's
the line here.
Defensive line through there.
Definitely fair play to Connor there. He backed off. He could have got a bit silly, but he didn't. He knows his racing.
I want to see how quick this Williams is now with the Lotus behind him. Can he hold it? DRS, I don't think it's been activated. It's next lap, isn't it?
It is activated.
I can't
DRS
see. It's not open.
No.
But he's going for a move, Creations. Oh, no, he backs out.
Oh.
Just ducks back inside again.
Just applying the pressure.
Yeah, just letting Wayne know that he's there.
He's more than capable and confident enough to make a pass when he needs to make a pass. He knows how many laps he's got on his tyres. He's
behind. We've got George making a move on Juan Luke by the looks of it. Sam in it. And George has made it stick. Nice move there. Textbook overtake.
Creations has made it
stick.
Creations has just taken first place.
Oh, good move there from Creations. Just watching on board there with Sam, who's trying to get his position back. Looking back, he's got Colandinho and Kai right behind him. So it's all happening here. We'll jump. Contact there. Colin Dini just ran into the back of Sam. Thankfully, no damage, no end plate damage there, but a definite shunt from behind. Just stay on board there. Yep, no worries, matey. You rage quit, you'll get a race ban for that. Yeah. And also, what's interesting here is that... Hang on, sorry, Stig. Wasn't commentating. Got to Creations, has just opened up. Mansell went wide going into the tight left-hander, going up the hill. And that's also allowed Juan Luke just to close up a little bit there on Mansell or Wayne Hammer.
There's a serious battle going between fifth and sixth with Sam and Daniel. Oh, yeah. Love Sam's gearbox. Totally. He's got him.
Let's have a look there. Oh, my goodness me.
Is he in a Ferrari? That Ferrari's got the pace on.
Oh, I'm trying to get the... Give me the broadcast mode, you stupid Twitch. Ugh. Yep. Oh, he's got a bit wide. He's got a bit wide there. Sam's going back up the inside. And Kai is right behind this. Now, they're both going to have DRS now on Colandinho, but the Ferrari is incredibly, insanely fast in a straight line. Colandinho goes to the left of the side. He's made his one defensive move. I think they're going to go in as they are into the corner. Yep, there we go. Colandinho through. Oh, Colandinho's gone wide.
He's gone wide. What a great move from Kai.
And Kai's overtaking George. No, not George, sorry.
Sam. Oh,
Sam. Sam's gone from fourth to seventh in the space of a lap and a bit.
Is he losing grip? How many?
Well, yeah, because I tell you something, Robbie.
Kai's over Colandinho. Kai's making a pass.
Yeah, he is. I found with the Force India that the tyre wear is not good. I wonder if them tyres are starting to go off. The first pit stops, I reckon, around about lap eight. So, of course, they've used these tyres already in qualifying. As we know, Kai is a master at making the tyres last.
Yeah, he's so looking pretty solid, is Kai there.
Yeah. So just on board of Colandinho there. So he's got Kai right behind him. And Sam is still... I mean, Kai and Sam will have DRS on Colandinho. Colandinho's run wide, he's lost. Oh, Kai's gone alongside him here. Now, who's got the best drive? I think Colandinho has always pushed Kai a bit wide there. That was a bit of feisty defensive work from Colandinho. I think Kai might be fuming a bit in the cockpit there. A few choice words coming out of the Manc.
Sam back on Kai's
Yeah, that
as
has.
Well.
Now, I wonder if Colandinho could get swamped here, but again, can't stress enough the Ferrari is quick in a straight line. But Kai will have DRS, as will Sam as well. As they come into the final corner. Kai going for a bit of an undercut there. Needs to tuck in behind that Ferrari, which he has done. Now, will we see him pull out to the right? Or will he try? He's going for an overtake on the inside.
Right, there's just been a lag issue. George just lagged into the back of Luke. Luke did nothing. Right. I was looking behind.
Where's Kai gone?
You need to listen to this. I was looking from behind of Luke. His car was going down the pit straight, and all of a sudden, George was behind him. He got DRS. Yep. The next thing, George's car jumped forward, hit Luke's, and span off. Luke was in no, he hadn't braked, he hadn't done anything. There was a lag issue then with that. I just saw that.
Can you do us a favour? If you do say anything, just quickly hit
Xbox the, record that.
Record, there we go. Yep. You read the mind.
Xbox record that.
That would explain why the cars suddenly all gained position. Right, we're back on board of the race leader. That's Creations, followed closely by Wayne Hammer in second place in the Williams. These are having a very good battle, these two. They've swapped positions several times already. In third place, we have
Juan Luke
in the Force followed India, having a very good race. He's not that far behind,
too
actually.
Far behind by... He's only 3 seconds. Colandino's not too far behind him.
He's 3 seconds down the leader. Now, what's happened? Have a look and see what's happened to George. He's still going. He's down in last place but one, I think. Actually, do you know what? I'm going to do a quick rundown because otherwise, there's some guys here not getting the coverage. So we've got Creations currently in the lead, as you can see. DRL Mansell is in second place, just 0.4 behind. He's going to pick up DRS, but he is too far for an overtake. Juan Luke in third. Colandinho in fourth, with Kai Pollitt following closely behind in fifth. With DRS, but I think he's just a bit too far back to try and overtake here. Yep. We've got Sam in it in sixth place. Oh, Colandinho's run wide, and Kai's gone up the inside and taken fourth place. Can he make it stick? There's some lag in the room. A couple of cars sliding there, but Kai has taken Colandinho and moved up into fourth place. Very good overtake. So now Colandino drops to fourth. Drops to fifth. Sam is in sixth. DRL Alonso is in seventh place in the Toro Rosso. Jism is in eighth place in the Red Bull on the Prime tyre. Mustafa Shag is in ninth, just about a second behind Jism.
Forrester's come back from 12th as well.
He has, he's done well so far. Now Forrester's in 10th, he's 21 seconds behind the race leader. Venoms is in 11th, some 35 seconds down. He's obviously had, that was that incident on the first corner, wasn't it? And yeah. George is just across the start-finish line coming into turn one. I wonder if George has pitted, possibly. Yeah, he's on the Prime tyre, I think George has pitted. So we'll go back on board with the race leader, DRL Creations. Yeah, I think there's some lag issues. My Twitch has gone offline.
Right.
Yep, my Twitch has gone offline. It's not broadcasting.
To me it says the party is broadcast.
Okay, it might be the computer's frozen or something, I don't know.
Yeah, it's saying you're broadcasting on my screen, right?
Okay, alright. As long as it's broadcast on the Xbox, that's the key thing, because I can always pick up the stream.
Kai's gone back to 7th somehow.
Oh, wow, what's happened there? Kai's dropped down to 7th. Has he had some kind of incident there, which we've...
missed.
Yeah, he must have done. He's behind Alonso. I wonder if him and Colandino have had some kind of contact or Kai's just lost it on a corner there somewhere.
Oh.
He's lost a lot of time. He lost about 4 or 5 seconds there, so something's happened. But just going back to the leaders, and we'll just quickly work our way down. We'll get into broadcast TV mode. We've got DRL Creations in first. Followed by Wayne Hammer in second place, and Juan Luke is catching Wayne Hammer now. He's dropped back a little bit from the race leader, but he is catching second place. Fourth place is now Colandino. He's got Sam in it right behind him. Sam putting an awful lot of pressure on him now in that Force India. Of course, the tyres are going to be going now, so we're going to be looking at probably pit stops.
Maybe a couple of pit stops. Yeah.
Message from Mambo saying yes, it is. Yes, it is what? can you reply, please? It is always
broadcasting. You loon.
Thanks, Mambo. Cheers, matey. Oh, and Colandino's one wide there. Sam's having a look at the inside there, coming into the last corner down the straight. Sam will have DRS. Can he make a move on him?
Shag's not too far behind. He's pulling back. He's gaining on Jism.
That Red Bull's quick. He's found his car, I think. He's had problems with cars, but I think he's found the car he wanted. Oof. Just staying on board this particular battle. Sam in it is right in the slipstream now of Colandino. I think he'll be looking to make a move here. Colandino's gone left. Sam's having a look at the outside, but he's off the track almost trying to make the overtake there. I think Colandino has covered him off here. Yeah, that's a nice bit of driving from Colin there. As long as he doesn't run wide on the exit, he's made that one. He's defensively held it well. Right,
Sam's having a look at here.
Sam's putting an awful lot of pressure on Colandino. Right, let's have a quick look then, because I think we should be expecting some pit stops very shortly.
Yeah.
I'm going to stay on board the race. Oh, now Wayne's dropped right back, and he has got Luke about a second behind him. I think Wayne's tyres have gone. He's going to have to think about pitting. Creations has opened up about a 3.5 second gap. And as you can see there, look how close that Force India is behind.
I think you should go back Wayne to Hammer. Number 9. Go to Shag. Watch Shag.
On board of Shag, yeah, he's all over Jism. He's all over Jism. Look at that, oh, he's going to make the move. Of course, Jism's on the Prime tyre, and Skinny just blast past him. He says to his teammate, that's how you do it. So Skinny moves up to 8th place, which does surprise me.
How long Shag got left on these tyres, though?
Well, yeah, but the thing is, you'd think that these options are so knackered now that Jism on the Prime tyre should be in the prime of their life. He should be comfortable on those tyres, but he's not. Right, Creations is staying out. And Juan Luke has moved up to second as Wayne Hammer comes into the pits to change his set of tyres. Let's just see what time.
Yeah,
he was losing a lot of time there. We'll just stay on board with Wayne. I want to see whether he does an early stint on the primes or another set of options. It looks like another set of option tyres. Oh, he got held up there as the Ferrari came into the pits. That's not going to please him. He got held up by a couple of seconds there. In fact, did Colin Digne get out in front of Sam? Yes, Colin Digne managed to hold his position getting out of the pits as Colin Digne and Sam pitted at the same time as Wayne Hammer. These three guys obviously going for an undercut on the cars in front.
That's an early stop.
It is in some cars. I mean, if you drive the way I do, it's around about lap bloody six.
Yeah, I think I pitted on the nine.
I shred the tyres. Yeah. We're currently, what, on lap number 10. How's Venoms doing? I see Venoms is going to be in amongst this. I'm not sure if Venoms has stopped, though, yet, because he had that incident earlier on. He had to do an early pit stop at turn one. Just on, let's stay on board with the creations to see if he's... And the car you saw in the distance there is the Force India. What's
on board with Luke now? He's not too far.
And creation.
Yeah.
Sensible. Always lost a bit there. Grassed it a bit. Lost a few tenths there on the pit lane.
In the entry. Yeah.
Alonso's come pitted from third place as well. Obviously deciding his options have gone. And Kai Pollard is staying out, yeah.
We knew Kai would stay out.
Yeah. And he's jumped a lot of them. He goes into the lead. And Jism is now in second place on the prime tyre, which means that Skinny would have pitted as well. So it looks like most of the option tyres, if not all the option tyre drivers apart from Kai, have jumped in the pits.
Luke's come out in fifth. That's a nice re-entry there.
Well, Creations has gone for the sorry.
So,
Creations has come out on the prime tyre. That's a well-known tactic. He likes to get the prime stint out of the way early. He's come out in third place behind Jism. Much fresher tyres, though, so I would expect him to catch Jism fairly quickly. And Forrester is in fourth place. Of course, Forrester, I think, also had an incident, I think, at turn one and lap one. So he's on his prime stint to get them out of the way. But try and take them as far into the race as he can. Juan Luke on the option tyre. So Juan Luke, we're now seeing some split strategies here. We've got cars in front who have pitted and put prime tyre on. Juan Luke is on the option tyre, so he should catch these cars. And there's Mansell. In fifth place in the Williams. Right up behind the Force India. Of course, they've both just pitted. Colin Digne also. This is a good battle. One Luke's one a bit wide there. That's going to allow Mansell to get DRS, I think, down here. But Luke himself will have DRS and Forrester. Oh, I hate it when it doesn't give you the broadcast view all the time. Oh, it's so annoying. Oh, there we go. There we go.
Oh, lovely move.
Yeah, one Luke. Forrester's prime tyres.
Forrester's just not got anything.
He hasn't got the grip at the moment. And look at that, Wayne Hammer also. Well, he's not slipstreaming, but he's just on the fastest lap of the race. And oh, look at that overhead shot going into turn one. And yeah, Hammer's had to yield. Forrester's trying to have a position back at Luke. Mansell there yielding there, but he's got a good. Can he get a good exit? Get a good run up to the right hander? Can he have a little look at the inside? I think he might do, you know. I think Hammer might have a little look here.
Xbox record that.
Nope, he's backed out. Good driving, but these three or four cars here, there's no more than, what, half a second between the bunch of them. Looks like a really good battle. And of course, as Forrester's now based, a bit of a blocker now, really. Luke will be holding that. He can... Colin Digne and Hammer, there's a very close there. But as I was saying, Luke will be now looking to put his foot down, hopefully, and hoping that Forrester can block. Forrester's gone defensive into the right-hander. I think Wayne's going to make this stick if he can get a good exit coming up the hill. Indeed, he has done. Good overtake there by Mansell. Oh, Forrester's fighting Colin Digne all the way there. But I think Forrester's going backwards now. These prime tyres are starting to wear. As Colin Digne, yeah, he makes the move stick on Forrester, who's on the prime tyre. And I think just behind these as well. Yeah, there's Sam, who's also catching Forrester. Of course, Sam will be hoping that his internet connection holds tonight. Unfortunately, he seems to be victim of a lot of lag kicks, doesn't he?
Yeah.
In the F1 race. He's a very good racer as well, and he's had some rotten luck. He's having a look at Forrester. Forrester's gone defensive on the inside, going into turn one. Can Sam go around the outside and make this one stick? As you can see, oh, it's going to be close. Good defensive line by Forrester, who holds. Yep, he's held it. Can Sam get a good exit?
Back between, so yeah, Creation's just taken second back off Chisholm. One Luke's just coming up behind Chisholm now into third. They're all pretty tightly packed.
Well, there's our race leader, Kai Pollitt, still out on the option tyre. He's yet to pit. Yeah, I'm now on board with Creations, looking back there at Luke and Chisholm. I mean, Luke really should pass. And I think he might well do now. Actually, Jism's had to go very defensive already. What's going to happen here? Yeah, and I think Luke's going to make
Luke's
it coming
the
up the hill.
Luke has got the line.
Good overtake. Good overtake there. Luke takes
Xbox
the place.
Xbox record that.
Yeah, better grip and a better entrance and exit from the corner. And now Luke will set about hunting down Creations. Of course, Creations on the prime tyre. Luke is on the option, so Luke will be looking to catch up on Creations and try and ruin his race. There's a queue of traffic actually now behind Chisholm by the looks of it. Yeah, we've got Mansell and Colindinho. That battle. Look at that. Mansell's going to have a look and overtake on the inside of a. On the side camera view.
He's got the inside line. He's
Colindinho's going for the move as well. That's a corner cut.
That was naughty.
Yeah, can you record that? That was a corner cut.
Xbox record that. Xbox record that.
If he makes a move. Oh, and Colindinho's gone wide. I don't know what Colindinho's gone there. He's lost it. Colindinho lost it there. He grassed it. He lost the rear end. It wasn't a lag there. He just grassed it. He grassed his back wheel. And spun his car around.
Called that.
Oh, what's an over? Has there been an overtaking front there? Forrester and Colindinho's recovered somehow. He managed to recover it. I don't know how. He's lost a couple of places, but he has recovered it. And he's down in seventh place now after that. There is Colindinho. Sam. Just dropping through is Alonso close behind. Of course, he'll be looking to make a pass on Forrester as he's on much fresher tyres. And Skinny also not a million miles behind at the moment. Venom's currently in 11th place, a few seconds down on Skinny. And we've got Boris, who is desperately trying to get back into this race. He's some way down at the moment, 43 seconds behind the leaders. But all to play for, a long way to go. Yeah, still 42 laps to go. And jumping back on board of Kai, who is being caught quickly by Wan Luke and DRL Creations. He's got to jump on board there. Luke's making an overtake there on Creations with DRS. Look at that. Breezes past now. As long as he doesn't want to go in too deep. Oh, lovely move there. And Alonso's gone to the pits. Luke moves into second place with a lovely
Mansell
move there.
Mansell all over the gearbox of Creations as well. He could be
Luke's done some overtaking today. And here comes Mansell going for second place. Luke's had to go a bit
He's
defensive there as
Creation's
well.
Creation's gone wide. Creation's letting through.
I think he gave him the room there, didn't he? He's not battling these two at the moment.
He did. No.
But both Luke and Mansell have done some cracking overtaking tonight. Very, very good. Very good to see, actually, because really clean racing. These two are going to be having a battle because they're on the same strategy, Mansell and Luke. And Creation's there. In third place, just dropping it back a bit, which means that Kai, of course, has pitted. Where did Kai come out? Kai came out in ninth place. He's put fresh option tyres on.
Well, Kai went 15 laps, 14 laps with those tyres.
Yeah, he's looking for a two-stopper, isn't he? He's going to run these for about lap 32 and then come in and just run the prime tyre to the end. So, I mean, for most people, it's a four-stopper. It has to be, isn't it? But Kai's going to do a two-stopper, I'm pretty sure of it. Unless, of course, it rains, Robbie.
Ah, there we go. It doesn't look. The sky's
no.
Clear.
Yeah, it's the cloud that was here at the start has disappeared. But as we all know in Malaysia, it can come in quickly. Thunder and lightning.
And
hail,
there's still a long way to go.
Oh yes, indeed. Well, let's jump on with the race leader, which is Wan Luke. It's been a long time since we've said that. Wan Luke leading a race.
Race leader, yeah.
Not his own... Well, he gets DQ'd a lot. I think that's what it is. He's always been a very quick driver, as Luke, and a very fair driver too. He's had some rotten luck with disconnections and DSQs and whatnot last season. But Mansell's making a move up the inside. He's making an overtake. This is for the lead. Luke's giving him the room.
Shag's
he's looking
just
for the undercut.
Done a great move as well.
What a move by Mansell. Mansell takes the lead, but Luke's going to try and fight back here. Can he go around the outside, going out of turn two into turn three? No, Mansell's made that one stick, but Luke is in his slipstream again now. Will Luke make a move? As he come up the hill, Mansell's gone defensive. Luke swings from side to side, try and put the car off, but no, a great move. Mansell is not going to give that one up. So Mansell takes the lead. Luke into second place. Good fair overtaking racing there.
Man, on board now with Venoms. Venoms, he's dug deep. He's been pretty much at the rear all the races.
He's got George there just going up the inside of him now. That's a good move by George. Has he made it stick? I'm just on board here. No, I think Venoms has got the high ground, I think, has he? Yeah. They're side by side. Look at that.
Yeah, brilliant.
They're side by side. Wow. Great racing. Just looking on the back view there. Going back to the... Oh, they're so close. Look at that. George has gone defensive into the corner. I think Venoms is going to have to yield here, surely. But no, Venoms has gone through. Look at that. Oh, brilliant. That's awesome. Venoms holds him off. That was brilliant. I think Venoms there, I think he just had that slightly better traction, didn't he? Better grip with those option tyres. That was an awesome bit of overtaking, though.
Dude, wait till you see some of this footage I'm getting.
I can't wait.
Can put it on the website?
Yes, I can, mate. Yeah, I can download them and stick them on the website and Facebook as well. Not a problem. Right, let's have a look at the leaders. They're coming into... Is it turn one, is it? Yes, it is turn one. Mansell's still in the lead, but one. Luke just 3 or 4 tenths behind him. Oh, Luke's going looking for an undercut. Can he make it? Oh, he might have a bit of drive out of here. They're side by side, Mansell and one Luke. Look at the raw pace of that Williams. That's where the Williams comes into it. Some of that, just that raw straight line pace. Luke jinking from side to side, trying to put off Mansell, would no doubt will be looking in his mirrors. Good exit there from Luke, but I think Mansell should have this covered off. As long as he doesn't run wide, this is the key corner. He has to go defensive, but I think he's managed to hold him off there. I'm just going to stay on. Oh, a bit of lag there. Slight lag spike, I noticed. Just going to stay on board this. I just want to until we get to the end of this lap, just to see if there's an overtaking possibility for Luke on Mansell. Then I will have a quick look through down the field. Robbie, could you do me a favour, buddy? Could you have a little smidgen for the race director and see if we have any penalties to speak of? Thank you, my friend. If I'm rabbiting too much, tell me STFU, by the way, as well. Coming down the back straight, and Luke has DRS just 3 tenths down on Mansell. He has DRS wide open. Have a look at the back of the car. Well, it should be wide open, but it's not, but I think it is. He needs to get a nice tight line, get on the power early, which he has done now.
3 second penalty.
Here comes
Luke's
Luke.
Carrying a 6 second.
All right, but Luke's now taking first place off Mansell with DRS. I think that's all she wrote on that move. I don't think Mansell can hold him off. No, Mansell gives room. Good driving again. And yet another overtaking move from one Luke. Cracking move there. Retakes the lead. These two are having a right scrap. Great to see.
This is on a shag. Beautifully clean race. He's had one warning.
Well, Creations at the moment is... it says here he's 2.87 seconds behind the leader. Yeah, you can see Mansell's car in front. Season third. Colandinho is fourth, 7 seconds behind the race leader. Sam is fifth, right behind Colandinho. Alonso is sixth. He's 10 seconds down on the option tyre. Mustafa Shag having a good race in seventh place, 14 seconds down. Kai Pollitt is in eighth place. He's made an overtake. He's 20 seconds down the race leader. Jism's in ninth. Jism's pitted and put the option tyres on. So he's done his prime stint. He'll be on the faster tyre for the... Should be for the rest of the race. Venoms in 10th. George in 11th, just behind Venoms. And Forrester is just behind George. The two Saubers, unfortunately, at the moment, bringing up the rear. And I think, Robbie, will be for the guys who pitted options at the first stop, who went back on the options, we might be looking at pit stops again fairly shortly in about two or three laps' time.
Oh, Mansell's just taken Luke on the straight.
Has he? Oh, wow. Oh, yeah, missing all these straight, great moves.
He's got him into the first corner. Beautiful overtake.
Now, will Luke have a look back again? Luke's tucked behind him. Here comes Luke. DRS is open. I think Luke's going to take the position back again. There goes Luke. These two are having such a battle under the braking. Who's got the balls to break the latest?
I think Luke's going to make it stick.
Yeah, that's a good move.
Yeah, nice racing.
Yeah, very good racing. These two are just going at hammer and tong at the moment. I'm just going to see where Creations is in relation to this. Yeah, Creations is still there, but he's about 4 seconds down. But I tell you what, considering he's on the prime tyre, these two have not shot away as quickly as I thought they might do.
He's quick around here.
Oh, Creations, yeah. But again, it's worth noting that the option tyres now and the cars in front will be starting to get quite worn now. They've done about, 9-10 laps on this second set of tyres. They're not going to be at their best.
No.
I'd imagine they'd be coming in the next couple or so laps to put fresh boots on. Just going to stay on board this battle. I just want to see if Mansell can retake him on the straight, because he's totally within DRS. He's only 3 tenths down. Oh, Luke just ran across a bit of grass there. It's going to cost him a tenth.
Luke's already carrying 3 or 4 penalties as well.
Oh, he's going to have to be careful. He doesn't want to get a DQ when he's in his home Grand Prix as well, of course. Malaysian Grand Prix. He'll have to hang his head in shame if he gets DQ'd in his home Grand Prix.
Just on board with Shag now. He's catching Alonso for 6. He's dug deep as Shag. I think he's been involved. Maybe spun off. Well, he got spun off on the first
He got spun off in the first corner, yeah. Right, here comes Wayne, having a look at Luke. Luke's gone defensive onto the right-hand side of the track. Is Wayne going to try a pass on the outside or then try an undercut? He's going for the undercut. Oh, this is tight. Great driving again. Good awareness from both drivers, but Luke holds position. This is some scrap these two are having. This is going to go down as one of the best scraps I think we've ever had in DRL. Oh, and Wayne's dived. Oh, has he gone for a move? Oh, they've made contact. Robbie, can you record that? Top two cars, Luke and Colandinho.
I'm not on it.
I've watched that. Wayne's actually yielded position, which is good. What happened was, going into the right-hand corner, Wayne shot up the inside. It wasn't really a dive bomb. He just outbraked himself. But he has yielded the position back, so I would say no further action
fair
at all.
Luke would be happy with that, yeah, definitely. Yep.
But it has allowed Creations to draw right up behind him, of course. And now Creations' tyres, of course, are in good nick. He's on the prime tyre.
Shag making a move on Alonso here for...
Just jump back on that one. Contact.
Yeah. Shag hasn't got any damage. I hope he hasn't got any damage. It was just a...
There was no one's fault, that. He just... Alonso, I think Shag just went a bit deep into the corner, didn't he? Yeah.
Little love bump.
He seems to be okay. He's cornering okay. I don't think he's lost too much. I'm going to have to jump back on the leaders, though, because we've... There's Creations making a move, and Wayne Hammer on the outside, going into the final corner. Can he make this stick? What is going to happen here? There the two cars are. Creations is... Yeah, Creations has got DRS. The cars are alongside, but Wayne is fighting that. That Williams is so quick in a straight line. He's not allowing Creations to go. Who's got the balls on the brakes? This is the question. Creations goes right. Hammer goes left. Colandinho takes Sam to fourth place, and Creation makes the move. Stick goes into second place. Great move there. Oh, catch a breath. Mansell's in third, and Colandinho is in fourth place.
Record that.
Having a real... ding-dong of a battle with Sam in it. These five, there's only, 5 seconds between the first five cars? That's and they're all on different race. Strategies.
Yeah.
Oh, I need to take a breath here. But as it stands at the moment, I would say that Creations is in the prime position now, because he's getting his prime stint out of the way. For the rest of the race, providing it stays dry, he's going to be on the quicker tyre. But the guys around him...
Shag's making a move on Alonso. Shag's going to make it stick this time. Come on.
They've contacted. They've crashed.
Xbox, record that.
They've crashed. Xbox, it's the Toro Rosso and the Red Bull, they've crashed. Oh dear, oh dear, what has happened there? I think Ginny's car's stationary, I think he's recording, he's retired. Oh no. Oh, that's dreadful. And I think Alonso's, he's got away with that one. I caught the end of it, so I don't know what's, we'll have to review that one after the race, Robbie, I think. Oh dear, oh dear. Are you still there, mate?
Yes, yes. I've just been explaining. Yep. I was on mute then.
Basically,
on my screen, Shag, and for me, Alonso just came onto Shag, literally just went left. Shag was on his inside making a move, and Alonso just drifted left and just took Shag into the wall.
I caught it on stream, literally from the side on view, but it was at the moment of impact when I caught it, because you mentioned the move and I just jumped straight to it. We'll have a look at the stream, have a look at your recording as well, obviously. And very unfortunate for Skinny, who was having a good race. He'd fought hard to come back after the incident at turn one.
That's awful. I really feel for him. It's
a shame that he's retired, because there's still an awful long way to go. I appreciate the fact that he might have lost a wing, but even so, there's still a long way to go in this race.
Yeah, it's tough. It's that rage, I'm not going to.
Well, I remember the last race, Robbie, when you and I came together on lap one. It was so tempting to press the B button, you know. Got to carry on.
See, with DRL, we don't do that, you know. But
yeah,
you know, Shaggy's, he will be like, ah. But you don't.
He'll be fuming.
Yeah,
he'll be absolutely fuming.
And I do feel for him.
And Luke's, is Luke pitting? No, Luke's staying out. I think Luke's option tyres, they'll be coming to the end of their life. And Wayne Hammer has pitted. He's gone for an undercut. Good thinking by Wayne. That's going to get him track position again. Because Luke has stayed out on the option tyre in the lead, but his options must be just about burnt out now. And of course, Creations Primes are still nice and fresh.
And
he's right behind
Creations
Luke.
He's catching. Creations
he's right on
right
him now.
Luke.
Right on him. Yeah. Mm. But I think, I wonder whether when Wayne comes out, cause I think Luke will pit at the end of this lap, I'm pretty sure he will do, but Wayne might well retake the position back, because that undercut does work around here. It's a couple of 3 seconds. All right, quick look through the field. It's Kai Pollitt 11 seconds behind, Jism's in fourth, 17 seconds behind. So Mansell's come out 24 seconds behind the race leader. Now, what's a pit stop around here? That's the question.
Ah, yeah, what is it?
Colin Dino's pitted as well by the looks of it, because he was right up in this battle. So this is a position. Colin Dino with Sam as well. This lot were battling, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, we could have a right ding-dong. Right, I'm going to jump on board with one Luke. I want to see if he's pitting. He's just come into Sector 3. He's holding Creations off at the moment. But, see, he's having to go defensive, obviously, to hold him off. And that's going to slow him up a bit. Creations there got
a
much better exit. Yeah, I think he needs to pit. And again, where he comes out, I think it's going to be awesome. Now, Creations is making that move, as we can see with the Lotus there, the prime tyre.
Yeah,
goes past him. He's made it stick. Is Luke going to peel off into the pit? Well, they're both pitting. They're both pitting. Wow, that was. Now, this is the battle. Where do they come out? Going to jump on board with the third place, Ashley. I want to see what happens regarding, can he jump him in the pits, first of all? You know, the two cars in the pit lane. The Force India peels off first, I believe. No, it's the Lotus that peels off first. No, the Force India, get it right. Now, who gets out first?
Luke's out.
Luke's jumped in. And here comes Mansell, and he's got Colin Dino beside him. Is Colin Dino going to take the lead? Colin Dino has taken the lead. Oh no, it's taking third place, I should say. The other car's still staying out there. Oh wow, and there's Sam in fifth. So did they jump them then? Yeah, they did indeed.
I think they did. Yes, they did. Yeah.
Yeah. Luke's down to six. Luke's on the prime tyre in six, and Creations is on the option tyre. I think Wayne came back out on the option, so Wayne's going to finish on the prime tyre. So who's our leader? Is it Kai Pollitt again? Is Kai Pollitt our leader? He is. Mackay, of course, is on a T-stop strategy. We've got Jisman second place on the option tyre. 5 seconds down. Colindinho is third place, 10 seconds behind the race lead. And he has Wayne Hammer and Sam Innitt behind him. And Juan Luke. And Creations. So we have a real battle. Looking at the tyres, Colin Digne is on fresh options in fourth place. Sam is on reasonably fresh options. Mansell's on fresh options. Luke's on fresh primes. Creations is on fresh options. And he's all over the back of Juan Luke. And Juan Luke's gone a bit wide there. I wonder if Creations is going to make a move on the DRS here, going to the last corner.
Right, we're back in the set. What's off to Lou?
Yep, no worries. And yes, as you can see, Creations making a move there. Juan Luke hugs the inside. Juan Luke gives them plenty of room. Nice driving. Going for an undercut there. They're side by side. Who's got the DRS? I think it's the Force India's got the DRS. And it indeed it is, as Juan Luke takes back the position. Great driving again. Yet another overtake from Juan Luke. So these two going at it, Hammer and Tong. In front of them, you've got Sam Innitt there, and you've also got Wayne Hammer with Colindinho about a second up the road. So this is the battle for 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th. There's probably no more than 3 seconds between all 5 cars currently, but they are on different strategies. And we are starting to approach half distance now. Just looking back there, Juan Luke, he's under extreme pressure from Creations at the moment. But of course, the longer Juan Luke can try and keep that Lotus behind him, the better, because it's going to knacker his tyres, knacker Creations' tyres that bit quicker. So Luke will be calling upon all of his driving reserves, calling upon the will of the crowd, the 250,000 people who are currently around the racetrack watching this Grand Prix. And the 5 people who are watching it online as well. As you come into the last corner before the back straight, again, Creations will tuck up right behind him. Luke takes the right-hand line. Creations looks... In fact, Creations is not going to make the overtake here, or is he looking... He's doing what he did last time. He's got the move done, but Luke will come right back in with DRS. It's actually slightly naive racing, it must be said, by Creations there, because he allows Luke to pick up the DRS again. And there goes Luke, using the power of that Force India. So, I hate to be hypercritical, but it's slightly naive racing there from Creations. He's making his initial overtake move too soon. He needs to wait for the second DRS and then make the pass. Otherwise, Luke will just breeze straight back past him, as he's done for the last 2 laps, with the second bite of the DRS cherry. It is a very good battle between these two drivers currently. And there we see it from Creation's perspective, from the cockpit cam. And this will be extra frustrating for Creations, because it just increases the wear. Oh, he's run very wide there. I think he'll pick up a warning, possibly even a penalty for that particular manoeuvre. But this is very frustrating for Creations, because every lap he's behind Luke, it means one of 2 things. First, almost contact there slightly. It means he's going to lose time on the cars in front, and also he's going to be suffering from a lack of downforce and increased tyre wear on his own car, which could ruin his strategy. Well, Luke's run very wide there, has to go defensive on the outside. But again, now will Creations just hand back? He needs to just hand back here. There is a slight hint of lag in the room as well, which is not helping. But is he going to fall for the same mistake? He's falling for the same mistake again, and Luke's just going to undercut him, or certainly with DRS, and get his place back. Yep, as you can see, looking back from Creations' car, the rear wing flaps are wide open. Here comes Luke, under braking, side by side. Luke has the high ground, he's got the inside line. As long as it doesn't go too deep. He has gone quite deep this time. Creations is having a look around the outside. This is close, and Creations is off the track. He's going to have to yield. Yep, well, that's silly. It's Creations' own fault there. He had to yield. He didn't yield, he was on the grass. That was a Rosberg-Hamilton situation there from Spain all over again. Luke had the corner, he had the line. And again, I'm afraid to say, more naive driving from Creations. He's got great pace, but he's just sometimes hasn't got the nous. And he's in one look, he's dealing with an old pro. Now, I was just saying, Robbie, for the last four laps, you've had the same manoeuvre. Going down the back straight, Creations has DRS on Luke, yeah? Overtakes Luke, and then Luke undercuts him and gets DRS back. The mistake that Creations making is he's trying to overtake him on the first DRS. You just don't do it.
Stay behind him.
Stay behind him. Yeah. And Luke's just saying thank you very much on the main, on the start-finish straight, and just going breezing straight back past. Also, Creations going out of turn two into turn three. Creations tried to overtake Luke on the grass and came a cropper. Lost his car a little bit. It's his own fault. There wasn't a gap for an overtake there. So he's dropped back by a couple of seconds now, which is knackering his strategy because Luke's just frustrating him being on the course on the prime tyre. So it's going to take a quick run through the cars. We've got Kai Pollitt currently in front, still on the option tyre. He's done about 13 laps on these tyres now, so I'd imagine he'll be looking to take these back another four laps if he can, and then make his final pit stop. And the gap between first and second place, which is Colin Digno, is 4 seconds, so Colin is quickly catching him. Mansell's in third place, 7.6 seconds behind Kai. Both cars have to use the prime tyre. Sam Innitt is right behind Mansell, just literally a couple of car lengths as Mansell runs a bit wide there, coming off the right hand corner. Juan Lucas in fifth place. He's just dropped back, obviously, from these two in front because they're on the faster option tyre, a bit in fifth place. Creations in sixth place, trying to recover the time he lost in the last lap. Dira Alonso in seventh place, currently 25 seconds behind the race leader, just locking up there, going into the hairpin. Forrester in eighth place, a couple of seconds behind Alonso. Jism in ninth, right up behind Forrester, and we've got George in 10th place, and Venom's in 11th. And Kai is pitting. He's pitted a bit early, Robbie. I thought it might have gone a bit longer.
Yeah, so did I, especially with Mansell and Sam in third and fourth. Mansell's here in third on the back straight, and Sam's could be making a move on him here. Kai's going to be...
If you just stick with that, because I'm going to see, what's he putting on? He is putting the prime tyre on now. Can he get to the end of the race? 27 laps on the prime tyre. That's the question.
That's very doubtful.
It's a big ask.
That is a big, big ask. But maybe we know what he's like for tyre.
If anyone can do it, it's him. Definitely. Without a doubt. So we have a new leader, which is Colin Digno. He's had a great race. And of course, he actually did spin off. Do you remember at turn one? He spun off early on during the race, and yet here he is leading the race on merit as well at the moment.
So, Venom's at the back. Venom's has been at the back all this race, man.
Yeah, but he's not given up. He's 43 seconds down, but he's not given up. As Colin, I'm going to just jump onto Mansell's car and stick it in TV mode. I'm just going to go for a quick cigarette, Robbie, if you can just handle the commentary for 2 minutes, mate. I'm just on Mansell's car at the moment. He's got Sam right behind him.
Oh, he's making a move, Sam. Sam, he seems to have a little bit of pace on Mansell now, but Mansell's looking... He's a very, very good defender. Force India's got the DRS, bit of pace, making a pass. And he's made it stick, but then again, it's that mistake. Don't use your DRS in that zone. Mansell's now got the DRS and hopefully going to get the flyer on Sam for the rest of the lap. It's a silly, silly move. It's schoolboy error, I believe they call it. But still, great racing to watch. Again, Sam's on his gearbox. He's all over him, but Mansell can be a very, very, very cagey driver. He's hard to get past. He's a good, clean racer, and it is a joy to sit on board of him always. Oh, Sam's just got him on the inside. Does he know? Is it? This is. Whoa, it was a brave, brave move. He backed out. And it's going to come back down to the. The DRS zone. Ah, Sam's boxed clever this time. He's not used the DRS on Mansell. Oh, we have a retirement there from Venoms. Oh, that's sad to see, because Venoms, he was digging deep. He battled 31 laps on your own in last place. It's a tough, tough ask, it is. Fair play there, Venoms. Well done, mate. Unlucky. And once again, Mansell is just staying in front of Sam. Got the pace. He's got the skills. It could all go down to the strategy of the tyres, really. Yeah, Colandino's still looking pretty comfortable in first. Nice race. Mansell in second. Sam in third. Luke in fourth. He's got creations up his rear end, so to speak. Good job Jism wasn't in the fray then. Where is Jism? Oh, there's Jism in 8th. Racing alone at the moment. No, but he's just coming up on Alonso, who's just behind Kai there. So it's pretty close. Within 2 or 3 seconds. Going back on board with Sam there, making a move on Mansell nearly. Is he going to use the DRS? He is going to use the DRS. But once again, use that DRS, you go into the second DRS zone and you lose the place back. Good driving by Mansell there. He's going to open up the DS and hopefully take Sam.
Hopefully swap positions.
Hop on him this time. Yeah, it's that same old mistake with the DRS on the back straight. Sam's doing
Wayne's
it as
got
well,
the inside
Yeah, Wayne's going to make
Wayne, Wayne's got the high ground. He's got the line.
Yeah, it's been the same for the last 3 laps.
Yeah, I'm glad I stayed on this battle for the stream, actually.
It's a joy to watch, though. It is. You know, it's overtaking.
It's a shame that our race isn't actually the day after them, because we could learn by what we're seeing, couldn't you, if you know what I mean? We think, okay.
Mansell is catching Colandino, I think. Sam's only 4 seconds behind.
Well, there is Colin, yeah. There's not much, and Sam is all over the rear wing there of the Williams, looking very splendid in its white colour. And there's Sam having a little look there at the inside, but Wayne says, not a chance. See that big door? Yeah. I've just slammed it shut on you.
Again, cracking, it's going to be the DRS then. Activation zones.
Yeah.
We're going to do it again. I think they're entertaining us. This is exhibition driving.
This is what it is. It's a Sunday afternoon stroll around Sipang, isn't it? Like, you know.
Oh, there's contact. There's contact there.
Well, I don't think Sam's going to be dealing on DRS this lap.
No.
I think that's just a racing incident there.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. Or unless Mansell maybe braked a little bit earlier. We don't know what his tyres are like.
Yeah. Well, they must be starting to get a bit worn now. He's been on this set. It's about lap 23, lap 22, lap 23. He's got one more stop to put the prime tyre on. In fact, both these cars have got to run the prime tyre. Look how quickly Sam's caught up there.
Creations is making a move on Luke on the back DRS zone again. And then obviously Luke should get DRS.
Is it the same again, is it? Yeah, they've done the same again. And then Luke's just going to cruise up. He's going for the outside this time. Oh, it's a battle behind as well. There's an overtake going on behind between the Lotus of Kai Pollitt and the Toro Rosso of Alonso.
Yeah.
But Luke takes the position. And there's Alonso and Kai. Oh, look at that view from the back of the car there. Kai trying to find a little gap there we can sneak through. On the prime tyre as well, it must be said. This is very good driving.
Yeah, he's...
And there's also another Toro Rosso, not too far, but Red Bull behind, which I think is Jism, I believe. So there's a right royal battle going on here.
Not a great deal, innit?
Yeah, we've got... Did I miss that? Creations and Luke again. Creations had a real good look at Luke there. Luke just shut the door. Oh, defensive. Ooh, there, a bit of a corner cut there from Luke.
He's carrying a few penalties, Luke, as well.
Yeah, he had to borrow quite a bit of the grass there. If he puts it back after the race, I think the groundskeeper's going to be very happy with that. Bit of mowing there. Look at the Creations. This is great driving from Luke, though, because he has kept Creations behind this entire stint, and Creations has been on the faster tyre. Yeah, so this is exactly. A really good drive.
Is he going to use the DRS?
He's doing it again. It's the same mistake.
Sam's good for the viewers.
And Sam's doing it again. The same move. Alonso has made a move on Kai.
This is fantastic driving, though.
It is. Here comes Luke again on the outside. Creations has to stay in the centre. He can't move over to the left. He just ducks in behind the Force India. He's trying to go around the outside, but Luke again has got the high ground.
Good sideline there from Luke. Yeah, very good.
Very good driving. Sorry, Robbie.
You're not getting away from that corner on the outside.
I think Kai's made a move on Alonso just behind there. Did he make... Yes, he has. Kai's made the move on Alonso. Alonso's coming back at him, though. Oh, it's all happening. But Kai moves up to sixth place there.
He's just tucked him behind.
He is. He's caught them up rapidly. Now, I will just very briefly just jump on board with the leaders, because, of course, they've had a similar battle, and here they go again. We've got Mansell and Sam there. Now, where is Colandinho in relation to this? He's 5 seconds up the road, so he's just pulled out a bit of a gap now, Robbie. He's taken advantage of these two battling away.
So he's gone a little bit wide on that corner there.
And Robbie comes in. He holds that corner so well. He does have... Now, what will Sam do? Is he going to make the same mistake again? He's looking to make the same mistake again.
He's not.
Mansell's going to hold him. You see, Mansell should now see what's happening and actually allow it. He's tried to. Mansell's pitted.
Well, Mansell's in the pits, yeah.
He's going to put the prime tyre on.
Sam's cleared out. Colandinho's in the pits as well, so Sam now is...
Sam's race leader.
Lead. Yeah.
Now, Colandinho and Mansell are going to have to pit. There's a car also pitted behind them as well, which is Creations has also pitted. Now, what's he going to do? He's already ran the prime tyre. He did a short stint on the prime, so will he put the primes back on and go to the end? He's going to stay on board. I'm curious to see what his tyre choice is going to be here. Will he do two short stints on the option tyre? Yes, he's doing the option tyre, so he's going to fly. He's going to fly now. That's his strategy. Got one more stop to do around about lap 46, I reckon.
Luke's 13 seconds off the leader. Sam, he's going to have to come in the pit so soon, is Sam, I'm sure. I'm sure of it.
Yeah, he's going to have to run the prime tyre. Of course, Luke is running the prime... Luke stayed out, didn't he? Luke stayed out.
Luke's on the prime tyres.
Yep. I wonder how far Luke can take this thing, take him to about 44, 45, because if so, that'll mean just the one more stop to put the options back on again.
This was my strategy the other night, this was what I was doing, but then it rained, so I was...
The cat amongst the pigeons then, isn't it?
Oh, it was fantastic for me, and luckily enough I went out on the full wets, so... Oh, third, fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh. So close.
I'm just seeing if Sam pits or not, whether he stays out. What's Sam doing? No, Sam's coming into pit, so he'll be... I'm just going to stay on board to see what tyre. I think he has to run the prime tyre, doesn't he? I don't think he's run the prime tyre yet. So if it is the prime tyre, he'll be going to the end.
Just coming up on the corner now. Is he going to get out in front of Luke? Is he going to get out?
Unless it was 20-odd seconds, then no.
Luke's just coming onto the straight now.
Yeah, Luke's going to breeze past here. Sam's only just coming into his pit box now. The prime tyres go on.
Luke's
and away he goes.
Yeah, he's away Luke goes.
There's a
move into third and fourth. Oh, Jizz in there taking second place. Oh, he's not meant to stick. Colandino's gone on the outside.
Colandino's held it.
Kai. It was a little bit of a nudge, but it's okay.
Brush some wheels in. Kai's now going to have a look at Jism as well.
Obviously, Kai's on the...
He's on the primes. He's been on them for a little while now, about eight laps.
They'll be settling in nice for him, they will now.
Yeah, of course, Jism, though, will have to make one more stop, but he is on the quicker tyre. We've got some very interesting split strategies going on now. Let's have a quick little run through, just so I can, for the anyone watching, just so we can say what's actually happening. Right, one Lucas, our race leader, he has got a pit. Oh, look at that, he has now got Colandino and the gaggle of cars, Jism, and Kai Pollitt right behind him, and Luke's made a mistake, but no cigar. Come on, give me a decent camera view. Oh, hate it when it does this. Ah, here we go. Right, Colandino tucked up behind one Luke. Is he going to be sensible and keep out? No, he's having a look, and is it going to be the usual thing where we see one Luke just undercutting back again? Right, Colandino takes position. One Luke now has DRS, as does Jism. This could be very interesting. As you can see from the front-on view, Luke goes underneath with the undercut, and...
And he gets him. He gets him.
As happy as you like, he gets it again. He's done so many overtakes.
And Jism's on the tail of Colandino now as well. If he gets a good exit here, he's oh, it's looking good.
As you can see, look at the top four cars, less than a second between the top four, and Mansell in fifth. Oh, it's contact! It's contact.
Oh no, there's more contact. That's unlucky there for Jism. Oh, hope he hasn't got any damage.
Colandino's lost a couple of places there. He's gone up the inside. Kai. Oh, and Kai's taking a bump there as well. What is going on? And of course, that's the car behind Mansell. That's playing into his hands. Because Mansell is on fresher tyres than Kai. He's fitted the prime tyre to go to the end, but Kai is also going to the end on this, on his set of tyres, which he's been on now for about 8-9 laps.
I think Mansell's going to be coming in again.
Well, he's just fitted the prime tyre, so he could go to the end. 19-20 laps.
He's got the white walled ones on.
Is he option? He's got on. He's on option tyre. Okay.
I think he's going to go to maybe lap 40, 41, 42, 43, maybe on these.
This is.
Oh, I thought he would have. I don't know.
Yeah, he's going to have to run the prime tyre. But look at this, top three, two car lengths between them. I think Luke here now could be vulnerable to one of these cars. Is going to pass him and make it stick, because one of the cars will have DRS on him.
Look at that for 1, 2, and 3. That is phenomenal.
Here we go, looking back. Here comes Luke going up the inside again of Jism, and he just brands. Oh, and Colandino goes flying past as well. And they're all in the corner at the same time.
Jism,
what's happening? Jism has just held it. Can he get up the inside of one Luke? Not quite. Luke holds position.
Luke's gone wide.
Colandino
Luke's
going
gone
up
wide.
The outside in the Ferrari. Oh, it's all happening. Look at this. And Wayne Hammer has taken Kai Pollitt. Wayne's moved up. Here comes Colandino on the outside. Oh, what a move by Jism! It's contact!
There is contact. Unlucky.
Unlucky. I think, again, it's got to be a race instant. Jism locked up. I think Jism just locked up there. There's almost contact between Kai and Mansell. This is incredible racing. A second and a half between the top five cars. I'm going to jump on board with the race leader, which is not him. DRL1 Luke. Yeah, Jism tried to do a very cheeky manoeuvre up the inside, and I think he just made contact there, unfortunately. I take a breath after that, Robbie. That was awesome. Right, there's, as you can see, there's one... the cars are so close together. One Luke's first, Colandino second. DRL Mansell has now moved to the third. Oh, Colandino's gone wide, and Mansell takes second place, I think. Oh, Colandino comes back at him. Wow. Not quite sure what happened there. I actually think that might be smart driving by Mansell to allow him to get the DRS.
Colandino, DRS. Inside
now look
line.
At Mansell. Mansell could take them both here. Mansell could take. Contact, there's contact.
No.
Oh, no. Oh dear, again, it's hard to call that one. Mansell was making a genuine overtake. I almost feel that Luke didn't give him the rim he should have given him, really. But that is obviously first view. We'll have to have a look at that again later on.
Yeah, I think now, Luke was just holding his line. I'm sure he was. I don't know. We'll have to have a look again.
It's a toughie. Thankfully, Luke's got no damage, but the end plates are all in place. The wings there. I think it's just his pride. Oh dear. That was just amazing racing. Very unfortunate. But we'll. I'm just going to see what the shake-up of that is. And it is that Colin Dino is now in the lead. Jism is in second place, 2 seconds down on Colin Dino, with Kai right behind him. Of course, Kai will, I think, be trying to go to the end on this set of tyres. We've got Mansell is behind Kai, having had that just had that incident with Juan Luke. I'm just gonna have a just gonna jump on board with Mansell. When I check his wing seems intact. There doesn't seem to be any damage. So I think they actually got away that Robbie, Luke, and no damage, Luke and Mansell. No damage to both cars. It was
brilliant racing, was that?
But Mansell, they're all not very good exit there. I think Sam's going to close up on him there a little bit.
I think Kai's going to finish on the option tyres.
Do you think he's going to go in and pit and put another set of tyres on?
Yeah, I think he might.
I think he might have to, because he's just going to be a sitting duck, isn't he, later on?
Ooh.
Oh, Kai almost lost it there. The DRS was open and he almost lost it there. He managed to hold it together. Great recovery.
Of course, not forgetting Kai doesn't use any.
And here comes Mansell. Look at the pace of that Williams as he goes at the inside.
And
Can he make the stick?
He's got him.
He has done. Great move. Great move by Mansell. But Kai's coming back. Can he go around the outside? I don't think he's going to have the traction. No. Great move by Mansell. He's having a real battle this race. He's going to have a look at the inside under braking. No. Kai wisely sticks to the left of the track to avoid any possible contact there. Oh, this is one of the best races I think I've ever watched in any racing league, bar none.
Oh, Kai's definitely got Mansell all over his gearbox.
I'm actually on board of Kai at the moment on his cockpit cam. He's got Sam right behind him, you see, as well. So second, third, fourth, and fifth. There's a second and a half between four cars.
So we'll Mansell's gone a little bit wide.
Yeah, we're just going to switch back to TV broadcast mode there for anyone watching the race. As you can see there, Kai just took up a bit of dirt there. That's lost him a couple of tenths, a couple of car lengths.
He's gained it back. Mansell's been held up by Jism, I think.
And of course, Mansell's got this problem now. He'll make a move, but Jism has got the potential to come straight back at him again. So there goes Mansell up the inside. Kai wisely just holding back. So Mansell goes around the outside. In fact, the pitting. Kai's pitted, and so is Jism. Jism's hit the wall going into the pit lane. So Kai's going to fit the option tyre on and just blast it now. You were right. Good call, Wobby. He realised that the prime tyre was not going to go to the end.
No, definitely not. Whereas Conaldino out in first, he is on the. He's still on the prime tyre, so I do believe he will have to make another stop as well. I don't know.
And Kai's not been able to jump Jism. They've both put the option tyre.
But Mansell will have to come in. His tyres.
He has to come in. Yeah.
Off now. Yeah, surely. And he's going to finish up on the primes as well. Which, you know, it's a good tyre, but 16 laps on it, it's still quite warm.
Well, that's our race leader, Colin Dino. Just looking back there from Colin's car, you might just catch a glimpse of the white Williams in the right back in the there we go. That's the Williams there with the Force India tucked up behind him, which I believe will be Sam in it. And Sam's having a little look there along Mansell coming out of the hairpin. Sam's on the prime tyre. Of course, Mansell's got to pit and put the prime tyre on, which is going to leave him quite a long way adrift of these cars, actually. As the old saying goes in F1, it's always better to fight when you've got the prime tyre.
Ah, yes.
You want clear track for the options. And behind Sam, we have DRL Creations, who of course is also on the fast. He's on the faster tyre. He will have to pit again. And then we've got one Luke on the prime tyre who's recovering after that incident with Mansell two or three laps ago. Of course, he'll be looking to pit in the not-too-distant future to put the option tyre on, probably around about lap 44, 45, to give him 10 or 11 laps on the final set of options. In sixth place, we have Jism, who's got Kai Pollitt right behind him. Of course, these guys are now catching one Luke at a rate of knots. They fitted the faster tyre. Of course, Van Luke will be quicker at the end with fresher tyres. But here comes Kai. Lovely. Oh, Van Luke's left the session. Van Luke has left the session. Not sure what's happened there. Meanwhile, Kai has made an overtake on Jism, but Jism is coming right back at him. But I think Kai's made this one stick.
I don't know if he's lagged out or what, because he was racing it's, then and all of a sudden he wasn't.
Yeah. It hasn't retired from the session, i.e. been disqualified. I think it was just a straightforward dropout.
There's a battle going on between Jism and... Oh, Jism's...
Yeah,
right,
oh, he's bit of grass there. Colin Dino's been disqualified. The race leader... Oh, it's contact! Jism and Kai and Jism have collected each other.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my word, it's all happening. It is all happening. Can you try and record that if you can?
I didn't see much of it, but
I did get it on the stream as well. I can review the stream. Lap 42. Right. Okay. I'm trying a mental memory to have a look at that one. Which means that Mansell is our race leader, but he will have to come in and fit the prime tyre.
With Sam behind him. Then there's Creations in third.
Now Creations, I think he's sat pretty now. Creations depends what the gap is between Creations and Kai. Creations has got to come in and pit again to put option tyres back on.
20 seconds. Whereas, the difference. Kai well, is in sixth position now. He's just making a move.
Right,
on
20
Alonso.
Seconds.
No, Forrester.
Okay.
And Alonso. There's Kai going down
right.
Back straight now.
Well,
he
if
looks like he's going to take him.
If Creations pits in the next lap or two, he is going to be chasing Kai down at the end, possibly for the win.
Right.
If my calculations
Kai,
are
Kai moves
right.
Into fourth place. Very nice move on Forrester there. He's got some clean air now. He should pull away.
I am kind of surprised that Mansell's not come in yet to put prime tyre on. He's leaving it very late.
He's going to go to the end.
But no, he has to pit. He hasn't run the prime tyre.
Primes, right.
No. Unless he's just... if he's maintaining good pace in the options, he'll want to do as short a stint as possible in the prime. There is that to look at, yeah.
But Sam is closing him down. Sam could possibly go to the end on these tyres, maybe.
I think that's what Sam's looking at, but again, they're going to be very worn at the end. But I just noticed Sam's backside just slid out there. He's had to steer into the skid there to avoid losing the car.
Again,
the gap between the top two.
Far.
Yeah, the gap between these two is just a tad under 2 seconds at the moment. Just running down through. Creations, you can see both cars in front. You can see both leaders. He will have to pit again, mind you. I wonder if Creations might come in and end this lap. You see, Mansell will have track position on Creations, but he will be on a slower tyre.
And Creations at the moment is 24 seconds in front of Kai as well. So if Creations does come in...
Now's the time to come in, I'd say. If
now
I was Creations,
is the time
now's
to come
the
in.
Time. Yeah.
And get a good 12 laps out of your last set of tyres, maybe.
Yeah, because he'll probably come out just in front of Kai, which is what he wants because he'll be on the fresher tyre as well. So I'm just going to stay on board with Creations as he comes through Sector 2. I want to see what... if he does actually come in for a pit.
I'm going to be on board with Mansell as well. He's in first there. He's looking good. He's winning.
He's had a good race. I mean, yes, there have been a couple of incidents, but he's made a lot of overtaking moves.
He's not losing a great deal of grip out of these tyres either.
I mean, if he can maintain pace, the longer he stays out, the better. But Creations is catching the pair of them. Even though Creations' tyres themselves will be pretty worn down now.
Mm.
But as you can see there, the gap between the top three is
just staying out.
A fraction of five. Mansell's staying out. Now, what's Creations doing? What is Creations going to do? Is
Creations he going to stay out?
Is he going to come in? He's staying out as well. Okay. Yeah. Yep. Right, we'll drop back to the fourth place car. This is Kai Pollitt, who is about 22 seconds now down on the Creations. So, Creations, I think if he wants to maintain track position without having to overtake Kai, he's going to have to pit end this lap. Otherwise, otherwise he will have to overtake him. On track, the pit strategy won't work.
I was wondering what Wayne's doing.
Well, if he's let's just jump on board with Sam to see what the gap is. See, he's maintained the gap. It's 2 seconds. You know, so but got a bit further down the field.
9 seconds behind.
Yeah, we've got Jism in third. He's losing time on the leaders, which is surprising because he's on the faster tyre. Jism's in fifth place. We haven't seen Alonso. He's just made his final pit stop. He's shredded his last set. Shredded the last set and has put the option tyre on, which allows Forrester to move into sixth place. We haven't spent much time with Forrester. But he's been out on his own. But he had a couple of battles earlier on. There in the Sauber. Alonso in seventh. George in eighth place, who's been... had a frustrating race, I think. He had the incident earlier on. Has not really managed to get on the pace and recover. And then, of course, what's happened to Venoms? Has Venoms left as well? He disappeared off the timing sheets. Right, Mansell's pitted.
He retired, his Venoms. Oh, Mansell's in the pit.
Yep, he's pitted. And so is Sam. And so is Creations. They're all making their final pit stops now. Venoms, Mansell's going to have to go into the prime tyre. The two cars behind him will go onto the option tyre. Now, where is Kai in relation to this?
I'll just jump on board with him now. He's just coming onto the start straight now, is Kai.
Oh, this could be interesting. Right, here comes Mansell. Is he going to get out in front of Kai? This is the question. This is for race track position now. Oh, this is going to be so close, isn't it? What's happening? Where is Kai? Kai's still back there. Jism's just in the fastest lap of the race, the 139.4. So
Kai's gone into second.
We've got Mansell in first. Kai is in second place with Sam right behind him. Now, Mansell, he'll be creating a bit of a train here, I reckon. Oh, and Mansell's
one
wide. Is Kai going to take the lead? I think Kai is alongside Mansell as they go around the left-hander. I think Kai's got the high ground. Indeed, he has. Kai moves into first place with that manoeuvre. With Mansell trying to get his prime tyres up to temperature there. Just ran a bit wide, and Kai took advantage of that. And here comes Sam also. Sam having a look, and I think... Nope, Wayne goes defensive. Mansell goes defensive there. And Creations right behind these three cars, like a predator, just biding his time. As we come into Sector 3. Now, will it be deja vu, Robbie? Will it be Sam going for the first DRS overtake? We're about to find out. He's right up behind him. If I was Mansell, I'd let him go. Just say, go past me. Yeah. Actually, no, Sam's holding off this time. Right, Sam should have the second bite. Sam might have learnt his lesson now because he should have the DRS again and he should be able to now comfortably get past that Williams.
Well, he knows he's that he's pulling out tyres as well.
He's not making much of an impression. That Williams is very fast in a straight line. And in fact,
Kai's lost a little bit of time now.
Yeah. Of course, Kai's options, he's been running them now since about lap 41, so they're just about starting to... They've probably just passed their peak now, haven't they?
Yeah, and they'll be on the slow, slippery slope.
And that's going to harm him because Hammer's tyres will be perfectly fine to the end of the race. And also,
Sam's
Sam
just gone a bit wide there.
Yeah, and of course, Sam and Creations. And Creations have gone alongside Sam. Has he made the move?
He's taken full advantage of Sam's mistake there.
Creations has made third place. Yeah, good move there.
Sam's lost a lot of time there.
Yeah, he just ran wide into the... into the brown stuff there, and that cost him a second or two. Now, for guys watching, this is for the race win there. We've got different strategies. We've got Kai who's lagging a bit on my stream, it has to be said. His car's just bouncing a bit. which if it's in the race, the actual room itself is going to be quite disconcerting for Wayne behind him. But their creations, look at how creations has caught up with Wayne Hammer.
He's on the quicker tyre, his creations.
Yeah. Thing is, though, the one thing Wayne's got for him is that straight line speed, the power, the raw power in that Williams. And see, here we go. Creations is going to try and make the DRS naive move. Or is he? No, he's going to stay behind this time. He's learned. Sure. They've learned. They've learned the lesson.
Oh, Sam's just on the inside of Creations now as well. Sam's made a move.
Yeah.
And it's neck and neck.
It's just awesome racing. Look at this. But look at this. Look at the straight line speed of that Williams. He's going for the lead. And I think he's got it.
He's taking
great
it.
Move
he's
by
taking,
Wayne
he's
Hammer.
He's taking the lead. Contact. There's a little bit of contact.
Oh, and look at Creations going up the inside. Oh, my word. It's all happening. Look at this. Oh, my word. You've got the two Lotus teammates side by side. Creations on the inside now. Creations might well have the line here. Will Kai yield? Yes, Kai's yielded. Good team. But he comes back again. And look at Sam in the Force India. Oh. Yeah, Kai retakes second place, which momentarily was held by Creations.
Oh, there's contact.
Just
there's
incredible.
Contact.
Oh,
there's
contact.
Teammates
the teammates
have taken, each other
have
out.
Taken themselves out.
They've
oh,
taken
no.
Each other out.
Oh no!
Oh, dear me, that's.
Oh dear! Oh dear! Oh dear!
There's not going to be a happy director back in their pit box.
No, I think he'll be spitting feathers, mate.
Right. I'd be banging their heads together, mate.
Yeah, two teammates taking themselves out. That is just not cricket. Well,
no,
it's not F1 racing.
Pretty much guaranteed some points in that light, but.
Yeah, because those two guys, they're both particularly Creations, I think, going for the race win there. I think Kai might have struggled to pull off a win, but look at this now, Sam and Wayne side by side. One of these two, penalties permitting, is going to win this race. And is that Jizzen behind them? But Wayne's making a move on the inside there. Oh, Sam's went a bit
Sam
wide, he's taking
a bit
of gravel there. Bit of gravel off that. Look at the speed of that bloody Williams. But it's literally side by side. Look at the Williams. Look at that speed of that Williams. This is great in a straight line. I want that car. Oh, but he's went a bit wide. Sam, is Sam going to try and get up the inside? I think Wayne's going to just about hold the high ground. Oh, he's given the room. He's given the room. Sam's taking the place. Great
That's
driving.
Some good racing. Great racing.
Great driving by both of them there. Opportunistic move by Sam, but Wayne gave him the room. Bloody good to see that. And just dropping back, it is Jizzum in third place. What a race he's having. Started on the prime tyre.
His strategy's worked.
He has indeed, yeah. And he's only 4.3 seconds down.
And Jizzum is carrying a 5-second penalty so far that I can see.
Ah, right, okay.
Unlucky.
What about the two race leaders, Sam and Wayne? Are they carrying any penalties at the moment?
I'm just looking now. Creations has a 3-second penalty. Jizzum has another 3 seconds, so there's eight seconds on Jizzum there.
Yeah.
Sam, he's carrying the 3 seconds, and Creations is carrying another 3 seconds. So that's 6 seconds for Creations there, 3 seconds for Sam, unfortunately, because Sam has had a very, very good race.
He has, yeah. We just got 7 laps to go in there. Well, 6 coming to lap 50. Well, yeah, it'd be 7
Kai's
laps to go.
Kai's carrying 8 seconds so far.
Okay, here comes Wayne making a move on Sam again. Look at the DRS and the straight line speed. Makes it look easy, as long as he can hold it under braking, which he has done. Oh, Sam's having a little lip. I think Wayne's got the high ground again. Can Sam get a better exit as he's on the faster tyre?
I think Creation's carrying about 6 or 9 seconds. Sam's carrying about 6, I think.
Well, I think the problem is that the two Lotus drivers want their heads banging together because it's cost them a win. It's cost them a win there, definitely.
It has. Well, there's definite podiums for them both there, unfortunately.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. I think penalties withstanding, Creation's would have been my favourite because he just pitted and he'd already taken one place already.
Yeah, definitely. That's unfortunate. It is.
Of course, the advantage that Wayne, that Mansell has got, even though he's on the technically the slower tyre, because he's got such a short stint to do, he has no concerns about tyre wear. He can just rag the crap out of these tyres now, mix three it and rag them.
And the thing is, Sam is carrying 6 seconds worth of penalties as well, whereas Mansell is carrying none. You know,
clean, right, fantastic.
Yeah, very, very
lap
nice
50.
Clean race, yeah. Lap so 50 he can be clean. Confident.
Well, of course, we do have to look at that incident between Mansell and Wan Luke after the race. We need to have a review that footage just to make sure.
Which incident was that?
That was start-finish straight where they collided.
Ah, of course, yes.
Yeah, we're going to have a look at lap 42, I think it was. We're going to have a little look at that.
I've recorded everything, Shag.
Brilliant.
I've recorded everything, BMA. Every little incident that I've been able to record. I've also got lots of other great footage from different camera angles that I'll send to you. If you can get them uploaded to the DRL website, then
I can, mate.
You know, people can enjoy some of the highlights of the race.
Now, I appreciate we haven't got many viewers, and they're probably racers from DRL, but a quick plug out there, because I can't actually see what the comments are at the moment. Of course, we are at www.dynamicracingleague.com, which is our primary website. That's where we have our embedded YouTube videos, information about forthcoming races, as well as information about the league and the drivers' championship tables. You can also follow us at Twitter at F1_DRL. You can follow us at our YouTube channel, which of course is Dynamic Racing League. And we have two Facebook groups. We have a community page, which is Dynamic Racing League. And we have a closed group for drivers, which is DRL, Dynamic Racing League. And of course, also if you want to buy any cheap Xbox games, you can use our website with our affiliate Amazon, who will gladly take your money off you. So if you're looking to buy F1 2016, pre-order it from Amazon from our website. End of plug. Right, back on board of Mansell, and he's got Sam
Sam's
behind.
Got a little bit of piss, but again, the thing is, let's hope Sam doesn't do anything silly because he knows he's got 6 seconds of penalties.
Yeah.
You know, let's just hope he doesn't try and undercut and get a clip out on the corner or anything like that. You know, he should be quite.
Well,
he knows that
look,
he's not going to gain 6 seconds on him in the next four laps. This is down to driver experience and race knowledge, really. You know, it's down to these two to lead the way.
Well, so now there's a Lotus behind the
Jism's carrying a good 9 seconds, I think, as well.
Yeah, Creations has recovered.
He's got a 6 second penalty on him as well. These top, apart from Wayne, these top cars are carrying penalties.
So I would say, Wayne, really just keep the car on the track and you've won this race.
Yep. Unfortunately, we can't communicate with the drivers.
Well, it wouldn't be fair even if we could do, because it's not for us. We're not team mechanics as such.
No. I'm just so excited
now,
for the new game.
I can't wait, mate. I cannot wait. It looks awesome from what we've seen, from the test footage from the likes of Matty G and Limitless and the other guys. It looks a blooming awesome game. Now there's Creations looking to make a move on Jism. That sounds disgusting.
Doesn't Creation come from Jism?
I think it does. That's how we get life, mate. Very good, Robbie. Very good. Yeah. You need to record that one. That was a good gag. Right, and there is Creations. He just tucks in the inside there of Jism. He's gone for that move.
It's a good move. Not
now,
Jism
will
have the
We'll carry DRS.
Power.
Yep. Yeah, is he going to ejaculate? He's just spurted past him. He has.
Has he made it stick?
I think Creations is going to the inside. Oh, this is side by side. He's got the high ground.
Ooh,
it's touching the
room.
Touching there.
Yeah. I don't think there was contact. That was some good driving.
Well, I mean, they touched and there was jism all over the place. That's all I can say. But no more double entendres. My wife just walked in the room at that time, gave me a very strange look, and I'll no doubt get a telling off from our boss if he catches me being naughty on the streams. So back to the racing.
Tell her it was all me. But yeah, it's looking good for Wayne. It is looking very good for Wayne.
It is, yeah. Of course, those two are still having their battle. Oh, my goodness me, I'd caught them very, very close
just
together.
Hope there's no contact.
Yeah. There's been enough contact in this. There's been some great overtakes in this race, but there's also been some unfortunate contacts as well, which have had a bearing on the final shake-up of the drivers.
I don't know if it's been a lag issue, or I'm sure we'll find out from the drivers when we speak to them after.
But Wayne, I mean, I honestly thought Wayne would be a sitting duck on the prime tyre, but with a mixture of good driving and instance behind him, he has held the lead. He's done a great job. But Creations is catching him, but he's only got four laps to overtake and pull out a gap. Of course, he doesn't know that. All he's going to think, Creations, is I need to overtake those two cars in front of me.
Yeah. He's not going to catch them. He's not going to catch these two in front.
And the thing is with Wayne, as you can see, Sam is getting DRS all the time, but he just cannot. He hasn't got the straight line speed in the Force India to get past the Williams. The Williams has got a great engine. It's got the Mercedes engine, I believe. I think both cars have, haven't they? They've both got the same power unit. But we also we don't know what downforce setups they're running. Oh, Sam's having a little look at the inside there.
That's a tight line to take that on the inside.
Yeah, I think really at that corner to make an overtake stick, you're looking at the guy in front making a mistake. Otherwise, there's contact.
Yes. Yeah, it's not an overtaking corner, definitely.
No. Well, to be honest, on most Grand Prix tracks, the modern Grand Prix circuits, a safe overtake, there's probably only one or two spots on each track to do a safe overtake.
Yeah.
You know, you're kind of dicing with death, really, to try and, you know, make a move elsewhere. Sam's apart from Monaco, where there's just no overtaking spot.
Yeah. Sam's getting caught by Creations here.
He is, yes. Just looking back there from Mansell's car, and there's Sam, obviously, you know, right in his airflow, but Creations is himself just a couple of car lengths behind, and Jism is not giving up on this. He's just dropped off the back of Creations. Might be out of DRS now.
He's gone a bit wide.
But here we go again. Now, we've got two cars. We've got DRS. Who Sam's trying to get. He's going to have a look at the inside of Wayne Hammer. Hammer just sends it out. Oh, well held by
Creations
Wayne.
Creations got
there.
A nice line through there. Creations got a very nice line.
Wobble there from Creations. He's lost some time there. And the straight line speed is all apparent there on the Williams. Yeah, and Creations did lose some time. That's allowed Jism to just ride up behind him. No pun intended.
Well, Alonso's just made a move on Kai. Kai's to seventh now. They're all in the back straight as well, so they're not. Kai's 27 seconds behind the leader there, Alonso into six.
Yeah, Alonso then, the Toro Rosso just had a nice run at DRS there, which allowed him to
Forrest
breeze past.
Forrest is having a nice race in fifth there. You know, he's dug deep. He's been at the back of the pack for most of the race. And
well, talk about digging deep. They're on board very briefly there with George, with Boris, who has kept at it. And we'll have a half decent haul of points at the end of this race. He'll be carrying at least 4 points, which is, you know, he had the incident at the start, which lost him so much time.
Points on the board.
Points on the board, absolutely.
Second race.
We'll have to jump back
season.
On with the race leaders.
Long way to go.
Right, here we. Oh yeah, I mean, I've had a DSQ and a DNS so far, so I've got work to do myself in the Force India.
Luckily enough to have had a second and a first, so it's looking good.
I would have had a good finish at Australia, but someone whose name completely I can't remember hit me.
I must have had a mudguard on or something. I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, look at this. Look at this. We've got three-way action
close.
Here.
This is, but not forgetting.
Sam's closer than he has been at any time. Now, can he make the DRS? He pulls out to the right. Creations is going to pull to the inside. My God, we've got three cars side by side going to turn one. Please let there be no accident. Oh, there's contact.
It's happened.
Right, and we are going to have to definitely look at that.
Just recording.
Well, I'm going to make an early call on that. Pending look at the footage, Wayne was not at fault at all. He was defending against Sam, and Creations tried a very cheeky move at the inside. It's just not going to happen.
Yeah.
And so I'm afraid, unless the footage shows differently,
Creations given up the spot,
has he?
Very, very nice.
Well, that's in that case, fair play. He realised he'd done wrong. He's given the position back, but it has now given advantage.
Though, it doesn't help Mansell there with the time that he lost. You know, he's given him the place back, fair play, but
that might have cost him the race win.
Yeah, it might have done. I don't know if they knew that he's got no penalties, hasn't won, he's got nothing, so let's hope he's still managed to maintain his first position. I don't think he will have done. Unfortunately.
Well, there is Sam now coming down the final back straight on the final lap to take the checkered flag. Whether or not he has won the race on penalty count back, we'll be about to find out. Yeah. But here comes Sam, that's driven a solid race. Comes across the finish line to take provisional first place. Well done to Sam in it. And Jism, what a race. What a race by Jism. Outstanding race.
They're all carrying penalties.
DRL Mansell's got the win. He's got the win. Yep.
Deserved. Yeah, definitely.
Kai's going to come in seventh place by the looks of it there, some 30 seconds down. Of course, he had contact with his teammate, which cost him big time with about eight laps to go, which, of course, there'll be repercussions in the Lotus shed after this race. Probably fisticuffs behind the shed between the two drivers.
George.
Well done, George. He's stuck with it. Had a terrible start with the incident, and he's kept going. Pick up some useful points for Team Sauber. As is Forrester, the Sauber team, a good haul of points there, considering the problems they had at the start of the race. So well played to Forrester and George for a good set of points. So there we have it. And a screenshot when we get chance. There's the bubbly, well, the drivers first of all. With the token model. Force India's been given first. That was strange. He said it being first, but no, Sam has taken the race. Forrester looks like Mansell looks like he's second.
That's unfortunate. That is very unfortunate. We need to have a look at that little incident into that last corner.
Right, Colin Dino has left the session, or the race has finished now, so it's not a problem. Oh, there we go. That's the provisional finish. Mansell also picked up a penalty. Now, did he pick up the penalty for that incident? In which case, that might well come off.
It should be off.
Well, we need to know when he got that penalty. Can you check the race directory real quick?
Just going into it now, yeah. I'm going to have to go down to lap 56.
Yeah, if he picked up the penalty there, that will have to come off, and that could well change the race result. I missed it. I couldn't get to it in time.
We're going to have to talk to the drivers. Definitely.
Yeah.
That was unfortunate. Right, okay. Mansell.
Yeah, I picked it up when I got it.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
when yeah. when you and Creations made contact, was that the one? Yeah. The last lap, first corner?
Yeah. Yeah, mate.
You give him the place back, but obviously he lost the time on it.
Yeah, yeah. I think what will happen, because the penalty was given, I appreciate the fact you gave the position back, but the penalty was caused by you running into Wayne. So that penalty will almost certainly come off, which would give Wayne the win. But we will review that afterwards. For the time being, we're just going to go by how the game saw the finish. So Sam provisionally is the race winner as it stands. Wow, what a race. So many battles there. In your own words, in 2 minutes, how did it go for you, mate? And include your audio as well, please, chaps. This is to Sam, if he's there. Okay. Is Sam, are you there? All right, moving on to... We've got party issues. Wayne, are you there?
I'm here, mate.
How'd it go for you, mate? Some amazing overtaking, some amazing battles with Luke early on in the race. With standing, how'd it go, mate?
I struggled on the primes, but I was trying to hold them off as much as I could. But I knew there were options to go within 10 laps. So I just held it with my primes and just had an incident in the last corner. You know what I mean? First corner on the last lap.
Yeah.
Apart from that, I think enjoyed it.
You did a brilliant defensive drive with the prime tyre, though, because I think also what Robbie and I thought was spot on was the fact that you extended your option tyre stint to make sure it was just a quick, short blast.
Yeah, I had 10 laps
on the prime.
Yeah, 10 laps on prime.
Yeah, it was 10 laps.
Yeah, it was a brilliant drive, mate. I mean, some of the, you had great battles with Sam, but your battles with Luke earlier on was just a joy to watch.
I hit him. I went too close to him. Then I don't know what lap it was. He drove into me. When all four of us were together on the same straight.
It was the pit straight, wasn't it, when you all came
around
that corner?
Yeah, he just drove into me, mate.
We've got it all recorded. Yeah, man, we've got loads of clips recorded.
I mean, Robbie, bless his cotton socks. I think he did. I think he's basically filled up his hard drive with recordings. Because, a mixture of incidents, but also some amazing overtaking and racing. I mean, you know, it's unfortunate when you've got cars that are, and drivers that are so close together that incidents are going to happen. But the actual overtaking manoeuvres and the room that was given generally was awesome. And hats off to you, Wayne. You drove a fantastic race there, mate.
Cheers, mate.
So, stay tuned, mate, because Robbie and I've got a lot to go through. So the positions as they are at the moment might well and could well change.
I'm actually looking move at on that to... incident right now.
Yeah.
Right. Basically, sorry guys, finish your interview and I'll go for it after.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Creations, have you managed to get your audio included? All right. Okay.
Yeah, man. No worries.
All right. Well, had a good race there. You did the usual for you, which is the early stop on the primes, which seemed to work quite well. And then what happened with you and your teammate? Collided towards the end. Yeah. Well, what we noticed, if you watch the feed, we'll notice is that there was an error made by quite a few drivers on the back straight. On the first DRS, drivers would attempt the overtake, which meant the car being overtaken would get the DRS back on them. And we saw it lap after lap. And Robbie and I both said, when are they going to learn? When are they going to realise not to overtake in the first DRS? Because he was just swapping cars over. It was awesome to watch.
It was great watching. Great watching.
I cottoned on to that. That's why when I was behind someone, I wouldn't overtake them on the first DRS. Yeah. I'd wait to the second one.
Yeah. I think we saw that towards the end with Sam. You were just holding back until you got the DRS. The second, because, and also when you were defending at the end, it was amazing because that even with the car behind you, with DRS, you had so much pace in that Williams. It was just incredible. You're just holding them off. As I say, rather than having an interview with just the individual drivers, you can all talk for a couple of minutes, because we've got Jism as well, who drove a blinding race. I don't know if Jism, are you there at all, mate? I don't know if he's still in party.
Gone, mate.
He left a party.
It was a good race. It's enjoyable to be up with the big boys for a change.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I'm feeling the same way. I won on Friday night. You know what I mean? It's a nice car. And it's really, really nice just to be up in contention with the people who are usually 1, 2, and 3. You know what I mean? It's good.
I think last season I got lapped here. So for me,
great comeback, mate.
Yeah. Yes, mate.
Well, what it was for obviously I don't want to leave the party paused because we can't hear your game chat, so I'll tell you what I'm going to do, we'll discuss it afterwards. I'm just going to say for the guys watching on the broadcast, we had problems obviously with Stig, unfortunately couldn't get into the audio earlier on, he's had all kinds of connections problems, so we'll move on. A fantastic race, a real benchmarks, one of the best races I've ever commentated on. It really was. There's so much action all the way through. And what we'll do is we'll move on. Next race is China coming up. We have the F2 series kicking off on Friday night, which will involve me and Robbie, no doubt. And then the following Sunday,
definitely,
the F1 boys move on to China as well for the third round of the season. So a big congratulations to all the guys who finished. Commiserations to the guys who unfortunately either were lagged out or had race ending incidents. But to all the guys watching, thank you very much indeed. Robbie, if you want to lead us out, mate.
Well, that's it. Just great racing, guys. Great racing. Enough respect to you all. Brilliant, brilliant to watch. And it will have been a good feed as well, definitely. Well done,
fantastic.
Guys.
It'll be uploaded in the next hour or two. So on behalf of all of us, on behalf of myself and Robbie and all the drivers and all the guys and girls at DRL, thanks for watching. And we'll see you next Friday. Thank you. Xbox, stop the broadcast.